Hello, my dear students. How are you all? In the previous lectures, we completed the diseases, and today we are going to discuss about immunity. Immunity. Yes. So, listen, students. In our daily life, every day, we are exposing to a numerous numbers of infectious agents, to a large number of infectious agents. Even though we are exposing to a large number of infectious agents, only few of them are able to cause a disease, right? As you know, you may have observed, right, in our everyday life, we are exposing to a large number of infectious agents, but only few of them causing a disease. You may have a doubt, only few of them are able to cause the disease. Why not all the infectious agents can cause the disease? That is one reason, which is only known as immunity. The reason is immunity. What is immunity? Our body is able to defend itself from most of the infectious agents. This is because due to immunity. Now we are going to define immunity. Overall ability of the host to fight with the disease-causing organism, provided by immune system. is called immunity. So listen, students, the overall ability of the host to fight with the disease causing organism provided by immune system is called immunity. So our immune system is going to resist the disease causing microbes to not cause any harm to our body, right? Our immune system is only going to resist the disease-causing microbes to not cause any harm to your body. That is why the overall ability of the host to fight with the disease-causing organism provided by immune system is called immunity. We can define the immunity in one more way. Or, second point you can write, the resistance offered by your body to fight with the disease causing microbes is called immunity. Both are same, students. Only the way of writing is different here. Our body is going to resist the disease-causing microbes to not cause any disease, and that resistance is actually provided by the immune system. That is only known as immunity, right? Our body is going to resist the foreign particles which enters into our body. It will resist them in a manner so that it will not cause any harm to the host. It will not cause any harm or any disease to the host, right? That is only known as immunity. So it is all about immunity. I had given two definitions, but mostly we'll try to remember this definition because it is given in the NCERT book, and also it is given in the state book. Metric syllabus. In the metric syllabus also they had given the same definition. So mostly you will try to remember this. But immunity is the same. Immunity means what, students? The resistance what we are showing to the disease causing microbes with the help of the immune system is only known as immunity. Now we are going to discuss about immunity types. Types of immunity. It is of two types, students. Immunity, it is of two types. So what are those two types is, one is innate immunity. Innate immunity. Second one is acquired immunity. Acquired immunity. Before discussing about these two things, I want to say one more thing, students. This immunity is derived from Latin word immunis. So this immunity is actually derived from Latin word immunis. What is immunis? Immunis means exemption is nothing but students getting free from something is only known as exemption. What is students? Exemption is getting free from something. That means immunis, why they named immunity means, because immunity is getting free from the pathogen. It is making the host to get free from the pathogen so that the pathogen will not cause any disease. That is why they named the immunity based on the Latin word immunis, which means exemption. Right, so we are now going to discuss one by one what is innate immunity, what is innate immunity, and what is acquired immunity. Right. Innate immunity. This innate immunity, It is present at the time of birth. This immunity is present at the time of birth. As I told already, what is immunity, students? Immunity, it is the resistance which is offered by our body for the disease causing microbes and their products. Right? It is the resistance which is going to be offered by our body through the immune system so that the foreign particles which enters into our body will not cause any harm. It is only known as immunity. So it is the innate immunity. As it is present at the time of birth, it is also known as inborn immunity. Inborn immunity. What is this, students? Innate immunity is also known as inborn immunity. Why we are calling the innate immunity as inborn immunity means it is present at the time of birth. So one more thing you can see, students, at the time of birth the child will not come in contact with any antigen. The child will not come in contact with any antigen as he is not coming in contact with any antigen. This innate immunity is naturally present in the body. That means it is a non-specific type of defense. I'm writing. This immunity, it is developed before coming in contact with the antigen. So before the child gets in contact with the dust particles or gets in contact with the foreign particles or gets in contact with the antigen, or you can say gets in contact with the infectious agent. So before coming in contact with the infectious agents, this immunity is already present at the time of birth. Right? That is why we are calling the innate immunity also as inborn immunity. That means it is already present. We don't know what antigen is now going to cause. Right, before any antigen caused any disease to the child, this immunity is already present. So this inborn immunity, it is a non-specific. It is not a specific one. It is a non-specific type of defense. This this innate immunity mostly developed by barriers. For the example, students, you can see your room, right? The walls are the barriers which will not allow you to get out from your room until and unless you will open the door. So door is the only way through which you can go out, right? Door is the only way through which you can go out. You cannot go out through the wall, because wall is the barrier. Like that only. For example, you can see our skin. Through the skin, the pathogen cannot enter. So it is one of the barrier, right? So mostly this immunity will be developed by the barriers, right? And this innate immunity consists of four types of barriers, right? As this immunity mostly developed by barriers, this innate immunity consists of four types of barriers. Now we are going to see what are those barriers. Barriers. Okay, students. Four types of barriers which is developed by innate immunity or inborn immunity. Why we are calling the innate immunity as inborn immunity? Because this innate immunity is present at the time of birth, right? And what is immunity? The overall ability of the host to fight with the disease causing organism provided by the immune system is only called immunity. It is given in your NCERT book, so please remember this one. So four types of barriers. What are those barriers means? First one is physical barrier. This physical barrier, also we can call the physical barrier as anatomical barrier. Second one is physiological barrier. Third one is cellular barriers, and fourth one is cytokine barriers. So as I told, innate immunity is developed by barriers. So there are four types of barriers of innate immunity. What are those barriers? First one is physical barrier, which is also known as anatomical barrier. Second one is physiological barrier. Third one is cellular barriers. And fourth one is cytokine barriers. We are going to discuss one by one of these barriers. We are discussing about innate immunity. In this innate immunity, there are four types of barriers. It consists of four types of barriers. What are those barriers? Physical barrier or anatomical barrier. Second one is physiological barrier. Third one is cellular barrier. And fourth one is cytokine barrier. So now we are going to discuss about physical or anatomical barrier. In this, skin is a physical barrier. It is the main type of barrier which is present inside our body, right? This skin will prevent the entry of foreign particles into our body. This skin is only preventing the foreign particles entering into our body. It is preventing us. And the second one is mucous membrane lining the respiratory digestive lining, the respiratory, digestive and urinogenital systems. Urinogenital systems. The mucous membranes, which is lining the respiratory, digestive and urinogenital system, will also help in trapping microbes entering our body, So see students, the mucous membranes, which is lining the respiratory, digestive and urinogenital system, and the mucous membrane which is lining there in these three systems will help in trapping microbes, which is entered into your body. What it will do? The mucous membrane which is lining the respiratory, digestive and urinogenital system will help in trapping the microbes entering which is entered into your body, right? It's all about physical or anatomical barrier, only two: skin and the mucous membrane. And that also mucous membrane which is lining the respiratory, digestive and urinogenital systems, right? Now we are going to see the second barrier, physiological barrier. And is first one, the barrier is HCl in the stomach. So once the infectious agents or the foreign particles enters into your body through the food or through the water, it will have to pass through the stomach. So in the stomach there will be HCl secretion. What it will do, it is this HCl, as it is acidic, it will kill that microorganisms or it will kill that foreign agents which enters into your body, or you can say it will also kill the infectious agents which enters into your body. So it is one of the barrier, HCl in stomach. And the second one is lysozyme. This lysozyme, it is an antibacterial. It kills the bacteria. It is an antibacterial. It will use to break the cell wall of the bacteria. This lysozyme is present in saliva and tears. So you can see, whenever any bacteria enters into the mouth, so you can see in the saliva this lysozyme is present. So in the mouth itself, the microorganism, the bacteria which enters, it will be die, because this lysozyme will break down the cell wall of that bacteria. Once it breaks down the cell wall of the bacteria, it cannot harm the host. So these are the two physiological barriers. So today only we are discussing about only two barriers. In the next class we will discuss about two barriers. I left two barriers. What are those two barriers? Cytokine barriers and cellular barriers. In the next class we will discuss about these two barriers. Along with that, we will also discuss acquired immunity, right students? So keep reading, keep going and do best. All the best. If you like this video, please like, share, comment and subscribe. Bye.